Welcome to Ragic. Before you start creating a sheet, let us spend a few minutes introducing you to some basics on the overall interface of Ragic to help you navigate the screens more easily. In Ragic, there are two types of accounts, a database account and a user account. The individual that registers and logs in first will set up the database account. After that, they can add additional users to the database account. One email address ties to one user account in a Ragic database. When Kaylin logs into the database, it shows her username here. Hovering over your account name will display the database account name. As you can see, the database account name is example. Within the example database account, there are several user accounts, such as kaylin@ragic.com, lillian@ragic.com, etc. One organization only needs one database account, and a database account can include many user accounts. Let's go through the database homepage. Click on the Ragic logo in the upper left corner to get there. Sheets are organized in tabs across the top of the homepage and in the center of the page. The sheets are listed under each tab. By moving the cursor to a tab, the list of associated sheets is displayed. For instance, the Support tab contains the Customer Service Ticket sheet and the Support Knowledge Base sheet. If you just started your database and haven't created any sheets yet, the center of your home page will be empty, like this. In your demo, you'll see that each sheet is shown with a blue hyperlink. You can click on it to see a list of records associated with that sheet. A sheet consists of several different fields associated with the function of the sheet. For instance, the customer sheet includes fields for the customer ID, customer name, and gender, etc. For every Ragic sheet, you can view it in the listing page or the form page. This is the listing page, and it looks similar to an Excel sheet. The records are arranged in rows, with each row being in one record. In this customer sheet, each row displays details of the customer's account information. Clicking on the arrows in the upper right corner will take you to the next page of entries, or back to the previous page. If you want to take a closer look at a record, just click on a field in that row and you will enter the record's form page. The form page displays the complete details for an individual record. For instance, in the customer's sheet form page, you can see the customer name, customer information, and their purchase history. Generally, when you design a Ragic sheet, you will be focusing on the form page. The form page contains all of the field inputs for a single entry, whereas the listing page shows a summary of the record with only selected fields from the form page. From the form page, we click on the Change Design in the upper right corner to enter the design mode for that sheet. On the left side of the screen, you can adjust the field and form settings in order to do things like change the font or the field type. To make it easy, the options and terminology are similar to Excel. The right side of the page is where you design your sheet. Whether the sheet is created with a free template, quick template, or from scratch, you can customize it however you like. Feel free to add, delete, or move any fields. The layout of this area will be exactly as you see it when you edit or create new records. When you finish designing your form, click Save above the form in the center of the page and click Exit to go back to the form page. If you want to go to the listing page from the form page, click this arrow in the upper left corner. Now we're on the listing page. We can also change design for the listing page. However, the design mode for the listing page only allows you to modify how the listing page is displayed on your screen. For instance, you can choose which fields you want to display and change the height and width of your fields. Sometimes users go to the Form Tools menu when they are in the design mode of the listing page and find there aren't many options and wonder if there is something wrong. Since you can only modify how the listing page is displayed, there aren't as many options available compared to the design mode of a form. Next time, if you can't find the function you want in the Form Tools menu, check if you are in the design mode of the listing page. If so, you need to toggle to the form page by clicking on the arrow in the upper right corner, and you will have additional functions available to you in the Form Tools menu. That's it for the interface introduction to Ragic. Now that you are familiar with the overall interface of Ragic, the next video will show you how to create a Ragic sheet and add new entries. There are many different Ragic tutorials for more advanced functions, such as setting access rights, approvals, barcodes, mail merge, and so on. To get more information, subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to get notifications for the latest videos. If you have any questions, leave your comments below.